अरे ज्योति, यहाँ पे बैठी, काम का क्या हुआ?
क्या होगा, ये तो रोज का बोल रहे थे कि बाद में बताएंगे।
हमेशा जाती है आती है, कितना महीना हो गया तेरा पढ़ाई खत्म होके, अभी तक काम का आता नहीं, पता नहीं कैसा चलेगा ऐसा।
अरे मम्मी मैं क्या करूँ, मैं कोशिश तो कर रही हूँ ना, ऐसा लग रहा है कि भगवान अच्छे लोगों का साथ देता ही नहीं है। जो 10वीं में थे वो तो मुझसे आगे निकल गए।
तो ऐसे मेरी ज़िंदगी की शुरुआत हुई। मैंने अपना ग्रेजुएशन कंप्लीट किया और ग्रेजुएशन कंप्लीट करते ही मैं तुरंत अपने जॉब के लिए यहाँ वहाँ भटकने लगी। मैं बहुत सारे जगहों पर गई, बहुत सारा इंटरव्यू भी दिया, और लेकिन वो हमेशा इंटरव्यू के बाद कहते थे कि वो फ़ोन कर बताएंगे, वो फ़ोन करके वापस मुझे काम पर बुलाएंगे करके कहते थे। लेकिन हमेशा मैं उनके कॉल के लिए इंतज़ार करती थी, लेकिन उनके तरफ से कोई भी कॉल नहीं आता था। और हमेशा नकारात्मक बातें मेरे दिमाग में आते रहते थे कि मुझे लगता था कि क्या मैं इतने मुकाम तक पहुँच कर भी मैं कुछ नहीं कर पा रही हूँ करके, ऐसे सब फीलिंग्स मेरे मन में आते थे, ऐसे सारे चितनाएँ मेरे दिमाग में आती थी। लेकिन अब मैं किसी से कह भी नहीं सकती थी और परमेश्वर के साथ संबंध भी उतना घट नहीं था मेरा। और कभी भी अगर माँ मुझसे बात करने आती थी या कोई भी दोस्त मुझसे बात करने आते थे तो मैं उनके साथ इतना कंफर्टेबल फील नहीं करती थी, क्योंकि हमेशा मैं अपने मन में पूरी तरह से टूट चुकी थी। और कभी भी वो लोग मुझसे बात करते थे तो शायद मैं उनके साथ अच्छे तरह से रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं कर पाती थी, क्योंकि मैं पूरी टूट चुकी थी।
Did you get the job?
They said they'll let me know.
Begin with, soon after my graduation I started hunting for a job, and at once I got a job for a channel and I was called to work over there. But the next morning when I left to go to work, they called me up and they are like not to come because they wanted me to stay till late night and work like night shift and all that. But this was really difficult for me because I live in Anjuna and travel all the way from Panjim to Anjuna. That too late night was very difficult for me. And my mom was like, no, no, no way going to work over there and all that. So this, when they said no to me for this job, after getting selected and when you get a no from them, that really broke my heart. And since that instance I was broken up completely. Like I was like, now what, where is my future going to take me next? In this coming 10 years where am I going to see myself? All these questions were coming up and I had no clue of my life. And the main thing was that I never believed in myself. I would always underestimate myself. I never believed that yes, I can do this, I can do that. I never did that, and this led me into depression. I was so depressed, no job, I don't know how to manage, because after graduation soon I wanted to stand on my feet because I wanted to support my family. I was just waiting for that day when I'm going to get my results in my hand and go and look out for a job. So the moment they said no to me, I was completely shattered and I didn't know what to do at that moment. That was the most difficult time for me and for my family as well. But people kept on encouraging me at that moment, don't worry, God has greater plans for you. But I knew God has plans for me, but I never believed. So this was one of the main reasons of my depression. And then 3 months after that I was at home looking out for a job.
Thank you. Love your art too, man. Go for work, man. Do some work.
Dad, as I told you, I want to do my further studies.
Forget about the further studies. My friend, I'm telling you, you better join the job. At least you will get the experience of 2 years instead of joining and doing your further studies. See, I'm telling you, if you are going to be a professor or something like that, then okay, the master's degree is okay. If you are going to be a filmmaker, why you have to join that? Get experience, go to work somewhere, take a job. At least you will get 2 years experience. You will get a nice job after that. Try doing this.
But Dad,
listen, let me complete. What I am telling you is for your good only. I'm your father. I'm not your enemy. You understand that? So, listen. If you go to work, it would be better. I'm telling you. I've seen the world, man. More than you, I have seen the world. I know what is wrong, what is good, and what is bad for you. So, you should listen to me only. Understand that?
Well, I was a pretty chill guy, and when the results were declared, I was in a fix. You know, I wanted to do my further studies, but my father didn't allow me to do further studies. So he was after me to do work. Okay, and I actually wanted to take 1 month break, but he was like, "No, you have to do this. You will get lazy. You will do this." I'm like, "Fine." And the thing is, I didn't do anything at home. I used to just eat, go to sleep, play some music, and that's it. That was it. I wasn't doing anything productive.
Hello, is this Cyril Figueredo?
Hi sir, I'm Rebecca Pinto. Actually, I saw your ad regarding the job on the newspaper and I would like to join the company. Not yet, sir. What time, sir? Okay, sir. Okay, fine, sir. I'll be there. Thank you, sir. Bye.
Hello. Is this Jyoti Emmanuel?
Yes, speaking.
You had applied for Living Crest Channel, right?
Yes.
I have gone through your documents. I would like to have a word with you face to face. And for the same, you will have to come to Hyderabad. Is it okay with you?
Okay. Okay, ma'am.
Jyoti, have you ever stayed away from your family?
No, ma'am.
So, will you manage to stay alone here?
Yeah, ma'am, I'll manage.
Okay then, Jyoti. See you soon.
Okay, bye, ma'am. Finally, I got the job. But, mummy ko kaise batao? कोशिश करती हूँ
डैड आई एम गोइंग आउट नीड सम मनी फॉर पेट्रोल
for everything, I was dependent upon my father. You know, even the petrol money, I was dependent upon my father. And for everything, although financial thing, I think I was dependent, very much dependent upon my father. So I think for that matter, him forcing me to do work was well justified.
मम्मी
क्या हुआ?
मुझे जॉब मिल गया.
किधर?
हैदराबाद में.
हाँ, हैदराबाद में. इधर नहीं मिला जॉब?
मैंने कितना कोशिश किया मगर किधर से भी जवाब ही नहीं आया. मैंने हैदराबाद में भी अप्लाई किया था और उन्होंने 2 दिन में मुझे इंटरव्यू के लिए बुलाया है. तेरी क्या राय है, मैं जाऊँ ना?
मुझे तेरा हैदराबाद जाना पसंद नहीं है, इधर ही जॉब ढूंढ, मिल जाएगा कहीं ना कहीं.
कितना ढूंढूं, कोशिश तो कर रही हूँ ना कहीं से मुझे शुरुआत करनी होगी ना.
मुझे तेरा हैदराबाद जाना बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं, यहीं पे कहीं काम ढूंढ. तू हैदराबाद जाना मुझे पसंद नहीं, हम लोग कहीं नजरों के सामने कर.
अरे मम्मी, इतना अच्छा जॉब मिला है, अभी तू ही मुझे जाने नहीं दे रही है, मुझे जाना ही है.
ज्योति, मेरा बात तो सुन.
तब जैसे जानते हो, आपने अभी तक देखा है कि मैं अपने जॉब की तलाश में यहाँ वहाँ मैं कितना कोशिश करती हूँ लेकिन कहीं से भी जवाब नहीं आता है. इसी दौर में मैंने हैदराबाद में भी अप्लाई किया था जॉब के लिए और मुझे हैदराबाद से कॉल आया था. सोचिए, इतने सारे ना के बाद में अगर कोई आपको फ़ोन करके बुलाता है तो आप क्या करते? शायद आप भी उस मौके को नहीं छोड़ते. उसी तरह मैं भी इस मौके को मैं किसी भी रीति से गंवाना नहीं चाहती थी क्योंकि गोवा में मैंने कहीं पर भी इंटरव्यू पर गई, वो कहते थे कि फ़ोन करके बुलाएंगे, लेकिन कहीं से भी जवाब नहीं आता था. लेकिन फाइनली मुझे हैदराबाद से जवाब आया और मैं ये मौका किसी भी रीति से गंवाना नहीं चाहती थी. और एक तरफ से मैं इतनी खुश थी कि फाइनली भगवान ने मेरी प्रार्थना सुनी करके, लेकिन दूसरी तरफ मैं इतनी डर चुकी थी कि अभी मैं अपने माँ को कैसे बताऊँ. मैं जानती हूँ वो किसी भी रीति से मंजूर नहीं होगी कि मुझे हैदराबाद भेजने के लिए, लेकिन फिर भी मैंने कोशिश किया और किसी भी रीति से मैंने उसे कन्विंस करके मैंने उसे तैयार किया हैदराबाद जाने के लिए. तो फाइनली हम हैदराबाद के लिए रवाना हुए.
मैं कमिंग सर.
यस कमिंग.
Sir, these are my certificates. Have a look.
Oh, nice impression.
Thank you,
sir. You can join us from tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
So as I told you all that I was searching for jobs, and then I started looking out for jobs on TV, internet, newspapers, and then finally I found a job, and it was for a magazine. So I called up the company, and the next day they called me for an interview. I went there, but the place was not so favorable to me. I was feeling a bit of uncomfortable and uneasiness in that place. But then, as you all can see, I was so desperate for a job. I wanted a job. So I just said, nothing doing, I'm just saying yes. And even they wanted to hire me. So I said yes, and then I started working over there.
Hey, Sting. You know what happened last night? I came late.
And I'm knocking the door, you know. And Mama opened the door and she was with that white nightingale. I thought there was a ghost, you know. I laugh at Liz, I'm telling you a joke.
What's kind of?
Well, after the frustration grew, and you know, there was one time where, you know, I couldn't laugh at things. When people used to joke, people, you know, used to make me laugh, but the things that made me laugh didn't really matter, because I was really frustrated inside. And as you know, when you're frustrated inside, you cannot laugh at anything, and you usually take everything as a sarcasm. And when you take it as a sarcasm, it is not good, and which was partly not, it was not good at all for me. And slowly I was you know, going very depressed, I was going very down, I was, you know, going down my faith as well, and what I believed in, I was, you know, going backing out kind of from God. And in short, it was very bad.
God, so much work today. Head is paining. Boss also shouted at me. Shh. Oh, shit. It's better if I'll take a shower. What was my mistake? Oh God, I'm not getting sleep. What was my mistake? He's always shouting at me. I don't know how long this is going to go on. My auntie is calling this time. Hello? Hi auntie, I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine.
Yes auntie, why?
Because there was a job.
At present I'm working, but I'll let you know auntie.
Okay, no problem.
Okay. Haan, bye auntie.
ज्योति, तेरा जाना जरूरी है। हाँ, यहीं पे कहीं पे देखकर कर सकती है ना, उतना दूर जाना जरूरी है। बचपन से इधर ही हम लोग कहीं सामने पल बढ़ के बड़ी हो गई, अभी जाना जरूरी है। अकेली रह पाएगी उधर तू, हैदराबाद में तो उधर जाना अच्छा नहीं लग रहा है, मन को बहुत दुख लग रहा है। जाना जरूरी है क्या? एक बार सोच ले, दीदी का बच्चे लोग सब तेरे ही पास आते हैं पढ़ने के लिए, यहीं पे कहीं ढूंढ कर करेगा तो अच्छा रहेगा। सबको रुला के जाएगी।
बस मम्मी रुलाएगी क्या?
बॉस,
हेलो।
यस,
बट सर, नो सर, इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट। नो सर, what was my mistake?
Should I call or no? What if that job is not meant for me?
I'll call that sir.
What number? I'll take from the net. No, wait. God, if you want me to work over there, then you make a way for me. Show me a sign.
आंटी, हेलो आंटी।
हाय रुबेका।
हाय आंटी।
हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन, हाउ आर यू?
योर मॉम वाज सेइंग दैट यू आर नॉट टू हैप्पी विद योर प्रेजेंट जॉब। व्हाट हैपेंड?
नथिंग आंटी।
शी वाज सेइंग दैट यू आर ऑल अलोन ओवर देयर एंड यू फील वेरी अनकंफर्टेबल। सो व्हाई डोंट यू ट्राई ट्रॉफी टीवी? You remember the one which I was talking to
yeah,
you about
yes, auntie.
The other day?
Yes.
In fact, I had a word with Royston and he was like, tell her to send her CV. So, you take down his number now, I'll give it to you. You can call him up
okay.
And try.
Okay, auntie. Oh. Yes, auntie.
It is 96-23-84.
Okay, auntie.
Okay. You call him up and then you see. Talk to him, okay?
Okay, auntie. Okay.
Yeah.
Bye.
So then I started working for this magazine. And in the beginning, things were going okay. I was growing in my work. And I was also getting to know that I'm good at something, that is content writing. But then suddenly, I don't know, things started getting difficult for me. As you all can see, my boss is always shouting at me. So this is what actually happened. He would just call up and shout at me on the phone. And that would really break my heart because I'm a kind of person who take things very seriously and fast on my heart. And I feel really bad if anyone does that to me. And so this was happening to me and I was helpless. I didn't have any other option what to do. So that was one thing which made me uncomfortable at that work. And the second thing is that that place was a bit lonely. And I used to get so scared to stay there alone because the boss would go out for work meetings and I would be alone there doing my work. So I was lonely. I was very lonely in that place. I didn't have anyone to talk, nothing. Just work, go home, work, go home. It was, my life was just that for 2 months. And in between that, I had a call. So she was like, you join a better place. I was like, no, I don't want to just step out, switch from this job to another job. Let it be. If God wants me to work somewhere else, then He will only lead me. I was like that. I said, let it be. I don't want to leave this job. So I just ignored her. So I didn't wanted to take that decision at that moment of leaving the job. And now what I'm getting to realize is that I believe it was God's call. God wanted me to leave that job and switch to a better place where He wanted to take me. But that was the time I said no to His calling, which made things even worse at that place. So as usual, I went to work, and that was a day when God showed me a sign to leave that job. As usual, I was working in the office, and as it is shown in the clip, that my boss calls me up and he shouts on the phone, and I was hurt. I was feeling a bit hurt from inside. So I think of quitting the job and taking up the job which my mom's friend had recommended for me. So, but then I thought like, no, I won't take my decision, because I'm a person who never takes decisions by myself. I always like to ask, especially I'll ask my mom. But that moment I couldn't call her and tell her, because she would be worried. So I said, Lord, that was the time, I don't know what made me say this. I said, Lord, if you want me to work for this channel, that is Rofe TV, you lead me, you show me a sign. And if you show me the sign, then I am ready to give up this job and go where you want me to go. So as soon as I said this, so the very next second, my phone rings, and it was my mom's friend's call. So she's like, Rebecca, I'm giving you this number. It's the director of Rofe TV, that is Royston's number. So you call him up and speak to him, and he will tell you the further details. I was like, what? In my mind, I didn't tell her this, but I was like, what, really? This is actually happening with me? God, I just asked you and you showed me a sign right there. I couldn't believe what was happening to me. So I said, okay, fine, I'll just give a try. I'll take down the number and call up. So yeah, that's how I called him up, and he called me for an interview the next week.
Thank you.
Nesting, what are you doing? Come on, I want to talk to you. I had a word with my friend, you know, regarding your job. So he called me today morning and he said that there is a vacancy at Profi TV. So why don't you go and give a try?
Okay, thank you. Try.
Check.
Okay.
Something good might come. Okay.
Well, there were a couple of interviews lined up for me. You know, I went to a couple of them. I was rejected. Then some said that, you know, the pay wasn't that good. And so it was finally I was at home. And my dad said to me, like, there is a friend who said that he has a job for you. If you want, you can go for the interview. And I said, yes, okay, because I said, fine, whatever. Let me just go and give a try. As you know that, you know, David, when he was small and he was the youngest of the seven brothers, you know, nobody believed in him. And, you know, people and even Samuel, who went to anoint him with the oil, he was also very reluctant. But God has planned for each and everyone. And, you know, I think it was God's move for me to go over there. And I said yes, and I went there for the interview, which was off Profi TV. And, you know, I just saw some glimpses of Profi TV on the local television before. And that's it. I just went for the interview.
Jyoti, nice to see you.
Ma'am, these are my certificate. Have a look.
Nice. So what software are you aware of?
Adobe Premiere Pro and EDS. And I'm also interested in photography and videography.
Good.
We are happy to have you here, but we have some conditions. And first thing is that you have to make 3 years commitment with us. Second thing, you have to keep your all original certificates with us. And you have to look your accommodation by yourself. If you are okay with it, you can join us from tomorrow. Don't cry, don't feel bad. This is the time you need to be bold and take your decision.
I'll let you know.
तो फाइनली मैं अभी हैदराबाद पहुंची थी और मैं बहुत खुश थी और मैंने माँ को भी कन्विंस किया था। इस वजह से मैं बहुत खुश हुई थी क्योंकि मैं अभी सोच रही थी कि मैं अपने सपनों की दुनिया में पहुँच गई, जो इतने महीनों से मैं अपने जॉब की तलाश में थी और फाइनली मुझे हैदराबाद में वो पूरा होते दिखाई दिया, तो मैं बहुत खुश थी। लेकिन जब मैं ऑफिस में इंटरव्यू देने के लिए गई थी तो जिस प्रकार वो लोगों ने मुझसे बात किया अच्छा लगा, लेकिन जो 3 कंडीशन वो लोगों ने मेरे सामने रखा था उससे मैं खुश नहीं थी। ऐसा लगता था कि जैसे मुझे अभी वो लोग जेल में बंद करने वाले हैं 3 साल के लिए। ये सब सोचकर मुझे एक अजीब तरीके से लगने लगा। उन्होंने जैसे आपने देखा कि उन्होंने कहा कि आपको 3 साल के लिए यहीं पे रहना है और सारे ओरिजिनल सर्टिफिकेट्स जो है यहाँ पे रखना है और फाइनली मुझे रहने के लिए घर भी खुद से ही ढूंढना है। तो ये सब बातें जब उन लोगों ने मुझसे कहा तो मुझे बहुत ठेस पहुंचा, क्योंकि मैं जॉब के लिए इतने दूर से मैं हैदराबाद आई और फाइनली एक विश्वासी अगर दूसरे विश्वासी का मदद नहीं कर सकते तो मैं वहाँ कुर्सी पर बैठ बैठ के ही अपनी ज़िंदगी के आगे ज़िंदगी के बारे में मैं सोच सकती थी कि और 3 साल में मैं किस परिस्थिति में होंगी। मुझे उस वक्त समझ में नहीं आ रहा था, मेरे मन में एक बात चल रही थी और वो था कि वापस लौट जा गोवा को करके। फाइनली अभी मैं वापस गोवा में आ चुकी थी और मैं बहुत खुश थी अपने परिवार के साथ वापस मिलके, क्योंकि जब मैं हैदराबाद जा रही थी तो मैं अपने दिल में इतना दुख और दर्द लेकर जा रही थी, क्योंकि ये मेरी ज़िंदगी में पहली बार थी कि मैं अपने परिवार से अलग हो रही थी और परिवार से अलग होने का दर्द एक अजीब तरीके का दर्द होता है और मैंने अपनी ज़िंदगी में वो पहली बार मैंने अनुभव किया था। लेकिन जब मैं वापस गोवा आई थी तो मैं बहुत खुश थी और जो जॉब नहीं है वो टेंशन वो सब मैं भूल चुकी थी।
हेलो, इज दिस रोफे टीवी?
यस, हु इज दिस?
दिस इज ज्योति।
ओके,
I call to ask if there is any vacancy at Rofe TV. If there is, I would like to work as a video editor.
Okay, send me your CV and I'll get back to you.
Okay, fine ma'am, I'll send you. Lord, I put a word for job in 2 places, but till now no answer. I am so tired of waiting. I tried everything. Now you are the only hope. I heard so many testimonies of how mightily you have worked in so many people's life. Agar tu sach mein hai, to meri zindagi mein bhi ek adbhut karya kar. मेरी प्रार्थनाओं का जवाब कल ही चाहिए। ये छोटी सी प्रार्थना यीशु मसीह के नाम से मांगती हूँ, आमेन।
लॉर्ड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर गिविंग मी दिस जॉब पर दिया तो दिया लेकिन दो दो दिया अब तू ही मुझे सही मार दिखा आमेन
लेकिन कुछ दिनों के बाद में फिर वही टेंशन मेरे दिमाग में आने लगा अभी जॉब नहीं है अब मैं क्या करूँ क्योंकि गोवा में शायद जितने सारे मीडिया चैनल्स थे मैं वहाँ पे सब जगहों पर जाके मैंने ट्राई किया था और मुझे अभी कोई उम्मीद भी नहीं थी कि मुझे वापस गोवा में जॉब मिलेगा करके और एक दिन मैं अपनी बहन के घर गई थी और उनके घर में केबल नेटवर्क था और मैं ऐसी चैनल्स को बदल रही थी तो मैं लोकल चैनल से होकर गई मैंने देखा कि और भी थोड़े चैनल्स बाकी थे मैंने जहाँ पे मैंने ट्राई नहीं किया था तो मैंने उस चैनल्स के नाम नोट डाउन किया था बुक में और फिर घर जाते ही मैंने गूगल में सर्च किया उनका नंबर और मैंने फाइनली उन्हें फ़ोन करके मैंने उनसे पूछा कि आपके पास कोई वैकेंसी है तो उन्होंने कहा अपना CV भेज दो हम आपको वापस फ़ोन करके बताएंगे फिर से वही जवाब लाइक CV भेजो हम आपको वापस फ़ोन करेंगे तो पहले ही मैं गोवा में जब भी थी बहुत जगह पे गई थी तो उन्होंने सेम जवाब दिया था कि वो वापस कॉल करके बताएंगे इस बार मुझे बिल्कुल उम्मीद नहीं थी मैंने पूरा उम्मीद खो चुकी थी क्योंकि मैंने बहुत बार ऐसे मेरी ज़िंदगी में ऐसा हुआ था वापस वही से मैं गुजर रही थी तो मैं वापस नहीं ले पाई तो उस दिन ऐसे ही शाम को मैं बैठी थी घर में और मैंने सोचा कि क्यों ना प्रार्थना करूँ करके और जब मैं प्रार्थना करने के लिए बैठी तो मैं बहुत चिंतित थी और ऐसे सवाल मेरे मन में उठने लगे कि क्या सच्ची में मैं जिस परमेश्वर की स्तुति आराधना करती हूँ जिस परमेश्वर से मैं प्रार्थना करती हूँ क्या वो सच में ज़िंदा है क्या वो सच में मेरी प्रार्थना सुन रहा है क्या मैं सही भगवान के पास हूँ ऐसे मेरे मन में सवाल उठने लगे तो उस दिन पता नहीं मेरे मन से ऐसे बातें क्यों निकली मैंने कहा अगर तू सच में जिंदा है अगर तू सच में परमेश्वर है कहीं ना कहीं से मुझे कल तक मुझे जवाब चाहिए करके मैंने भगवान से प्रार्थना किया और अगर ये रोफी टीवी का जॉब मुझे अगर एक महीने के अंदर मिलता तो मैं सोचती थी कि वो मेरे बल से मिला या मेरे सर्टिफिकेट्स की वजह से मिला लेकिन ऐसा नहीं हुआ लेकिन मैंने आज प्रार्थना किया और उस प्रार्थना का जवाब मुझे कल ही मिल गया और मैंने दोनों चैनल्स में अप्लाई किया था दोनों चैनल से मुझे वापस कॉल आया उन्होंने कहा आप हमसे मिलने के लिए आ जाओ और मैं बहुत खुश थी और मुझे ऐसा लगा कि सच में मेरा परमेश्वर ज़िंदा है और तब से मैं वापस परमेश्वर के करीब आने लगी लेकिन अभी मैं वापस उस परिस्थिति में वापस कन्फ्यूजन में आ गई थी क्योंकि दोनों तरफ से मुझे बुलावा आया अब मैं सोच रही थी मैं अभी किस चैनल में जाऊँ करके तो फाइनली मुझे किसी इंसान की मदद नहीं लेनी थी क्योंकि मैंने परमेश्वर से प्रार्थना किया और उसने मेरी प्रार्थना का जवाब दिया तो मैंने सोचा कि इस बार भी मुझे वापस परमेश्वर के पास ही जाना है क्योंकि वही मुझे सही मार्ग दिखाएगा करके फिर मैंने परमेश्वर से प्रार्थना किया और मैंने उससे उसको धन्यवाद किया क्योंकि उसने मुझे मेरी प्रार्थना का जवाब दिया लेकिन अब मैं इस मुसीबत में थी कि भगवान ने दिया तो दिया लेकिन दो दो जवाब दिया जैसे कहते हैं कि जब भी परमेश्वर देता है तो छप्पड़ फाड़ के देता है उसी प्रकार मेरे जीवन में भी हुआ परमेश्वर ने जॉब तो दिया लेकिन दो दो जॉब दे दिया अभी मैं कंफ्यूज थी कि मैं अब किस में जाऊँ अभी किस तरफ में जाऊँ तो मैंने सोचा कि परमेश्वर से ही क्यों ना मदद ले ले और मैं वापस परमेश्वर के पास गई और मैंने उससे पूछा सही मार्ग क्या है वो मुझे दिखा
Jyoti, how are you?
Hi, Jyoti.
Okay, so what do you know about Rofi TV?
Not much.
Okay, let me tell you a bit about Rofi TV. So, Rofi TV was founded by my father, brother Anthony Dias in the year 2008. And now we both are taking care of it. And my wife, Zelia, she takes care of the production at the office.
So basically, Rebecca, you have to do scheduling and some editing.
Okay.
Have you worked anywhere before?
Yes, I worked for a magazine as a content writer.
Hi, Singh. So Singh, what's happened to you?
I know about CorelDRAW, Premiere Pro and Photoshop.
Okay, and do you know to use After Effects?
I know little about After Effect.
So basically your job is going to be taking care of the production, like clicking photos, taking some videos, recording and editing the videos and putting it up on the TV. Yeah. So you can join us.
तो फाइनली अभी मैं रोफी टीवी में हूँ. आप सोच रहे होंगे मैं रोफी टीवी में कैसे पहुँच गई, क्योंकि आपने मेरे इससे पहले वीडियो में देखा था कि मैं परमेश्वर ने मुझे दो जॉब्स के अपॉर्चुनिटी मेरे सामने रखे थे. अब मैंने उससे रोफी टीवी को कैसे चुना करके आप सोच रहे होंगे. तो ऐसा हुआ कि एक दिन मैं अपने परिवार के साथ बाहर घूमने निकली थी और सडनली मुझे रोफी टीवी से कॉल आया और उन्होंने कहा, ज्योति आज तुम्हें इंटरव्यू के लिए आना पड़ेगा करके. लेकिन तब तक मैं अपने घर से बहुत दूर पहुंची थी और मैंने कहा, सर मेरे पास तो सर्टिफिकेट्स भी नहीं है, मैं आज नहीं आ पाऊँगी शायद. उन्होंने कहा, कोई बात नहीं, तुम बिना सर्टिफिकेट्स के आ जाओ. तो मैं बस से उतर के डायरेक्ट इंटरव्यू देने के लिए मैं गई. और जब मैं इंटरव्यू देने के लिए गई तो मुझे ऐसा महसूस हुआ कि मैं इतने जगहों पर गई, हर एक जगह पे मैं अपना सर्टिफिकेट्स लेकर गई और उन सर्टिफिकेट्स ने मेरा कभी मदद नहीं किया. उन्होंने मेरे सर्टिफिकेट्स को देखा और वो हमेशा कहते थे कि हम आपको फ़ोन करके बताएंगे. लेकिन पहली बार मेरे जीवन में ऐसा हुआ, मैं बिना सर्टिफिकेट्स के ही सिलेक्ट हुई. तो इससे मुझे मालूम पड़ा कि ये बुलावा परमेश्वर की तरफ से है. परमेश्वर ने शायद मुझे हैदराबाद से इसी दिन के लिए वो लेकर आया था कि मैं एक दिन रोफी टीवी में काम करूँ.
Bye Sam, bless the blood of Jesus. Hi Sam, how was your day?
Good.
रोफी टीवी में पहुंच गए और रोफी टीवी में आते ही मैंने अपने ज़िंदगी में बहुत सारे बदलावट देखे. पहले मुझे थोड़ा कुछ आता था वीडियो एडिटिंग के बारे में, कैमरा के बारे में, लेकिन रोफी टीवी में आते ही मैंने बहुत कुछ सीखा. और सिर्फ इसके ही बारे में नहीं, लेकिन आत्मिक रीति से भी मैं बहुत आगे बढ़ी. एक दिन मैं मीटिंग को गई थी और सर रॉयस्टन ने कहा था कि तुम्हारी ज़िंदगी 3 महीने में बदलने वाली है. तो मैं बहुत खुश हो गई। मैंने सोचा कि अरे वाह, अभी मैं वीडियो एडिटिंग और कैमरा हैंडल करने के लिए शायद 3 महीने में ही सीख जाऊंगी करके। लेकिन ये वचन संसारिक तौर से नहीं था, लेकिन आत्मिक रूप से था। लेकिन 3 महीने में मैंने अपनी ज़िंदगी को बदलते हुए देखा। 3 महीने में मैं आत्मिक रीति से बहुत बढ़ते गई, और मैंने कभी सोचा भी नहीं था कि 3 महीने में ऐसे बदलावट आएंगे। मैं संसारिक रूप से बदलावट की उम्मीद कर रही थी, लेकिन भगवान ने संसार से नहीं, लेकिन मुझे आत्मिक रूप से आगे बढ़ाया। जब मैं आत्मिक रीति से बढ़ते गई तो मैं परमेश्वर के करीब और जाना चाहती थी, सिर्फ अकेली नहीं लेकिन पूरे परिवार को साथ लेकर। परमेश्वर का वचन कहता है अगर घर का कोई भी व्यक्ति, अगर एक व्यक्ति भी बचता है तो उसके द्वारा उसकी पूरी परिवार की बचावट होती है। तो उसी प्रकार ये वचन को मैंने लेकर अपने मन में मैंने अपना कदम आगे बढ़ाया। मैंने पहला कदम अपने परिवार की ओर बढ़ाया और मैंने उन्हें परमेश्वर के वचन बांटना शुरू किया, और ऐसे ऐसे मैं बहुत आत्मिक रीति में बढ़ने लगी। पहले मैं अगर बाइबल भी पढ़ती थी तो मुझे समझ में नहीं आता था कि क्या लिखा है करके। मैंने पहली बार पूरा बाइबल पढ़ा लेकिन कुछ समझ में नहीं आया। फिर अगली बार मैंने ट्राई किया, वापस मैंने पूरा बाइबल पढ़ा लेकिन बिल्कुल समझ में नहीं आ रहा था। लेकिन जैसे ही मैंने रोफी टीवी में काम करना शुरू किया, लेकिन जब मैं अभी बाइबल पढ़ती हूँ तो मुझे सब कुछ समझ में आता है। और सिर्फ समझ में ही नहीं, लेकिन जो लोग समझ नहीं पाते उन्हें भी समझाने की सामर्थ परमेश्वर ने मुझे दिया है, इसलिए मैं परमेश्वर की बहुत बड़ी आभारी हूँ। मैं दिल से रोफी टीवी का धन्यवाद करना चाहती हूँ। मैं दिल से ब्रदर एंथनी, सर ऑयस्टन, मैम सेलिया का धन्यवाद करना चाहती हूँ कि उन्होंने मुझे रोफी टीवी में काम करने का मौका दिया। और इस मौके की वजह से मैं सिर्फ काम में ही नहीं लेकिन आत्मिक रीति से भी मैं बढ़ती गई।
God, what is all this? Why I didn't know this before? All these years, without fail, I attended Sunday church. But, Lord, here your word says that we should worship you in spirit and truth. But I never found that spiritual connection with you. Oh God. What is all this? So confusing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So finally, I'm at Rofe TV, working over here, and in the beginning, things were normal. It was just normal, new place for me to work, new office, new people, but not everyone, because I had my classmates working over here, that is Jyoti Vadluri and Sting Parera. We were studying in college together, and I never even imagined that we would be together working in this place, because in college we were 3 different people belonging to 3 different groups, and it was beyond our imagination that we would be over here working together in unity, that too. So I was close to Jyoti because she would sit right in front of me in class, and we would always share tiffins together, and I would dig into her tiffin basically. But I never spoke to Sting, and he would always be seated behind singing and dancing, all that stuff. And we were like totally different. So we never knew each other personally as friends, even as classmates, we never spoke. So that there was that interaction between us was never there. So when we saw each other at Rofe, we were like, okay, so this is something very nice to be together with each other. So things were going usual with me. I started growing in my workplace. I started to learn a lot new softwares. I started to learn a bit of camera, then programming. Basically how the TV industry functions, I got to know about it. And Ma'am Zelia, she was always helpful to me. She always encouraged me and she taught me a lot of things, which I'll always be grateful to her. But slow things started changing in my life. And this change brought a complete transformation in my life. So it was on the 31st of December 2016 where I went for my first prayer meeting. And it was a first prayer meeting for me. I just went because it was a New Year program. So I went over there and the environment over there was completely different, which was not normal to me. I saw different things happening in that place and I saw a divine connection between God and the people over there. So I was like, I never experienced this before. I never even saw a prayer meeting like this before. This was totally different for me. But I just went with the flow and I was like, okay, this is happening. So I was just okay with it. So since then, since that 31st night, things started changing in my life. From the 1st of Jan 2017, things started changing in my life. Like my colleagues would reveal to me certain things from the Bible which I didn't wanted to hear anymore. I would say, no, please don't tell me anything. I don't want to hear. Because I was taught something different and what I was getting to know was completely different from the Bible. So I started reading the Bible. I had many doubts, many questions, like what is all this? I kept on praying to God, Lord, please help me. I don't want to live this way. Like so, I would feel so uneasy. I didn't want to live this life. But after all, as I said, it was the plan, God's plan. One, it was in February 2017, it was just before my birthday, that one night when I said my prayers and I was about to go to sleep, I closed my eyes but I didn't fall asleep. That moment changed my life. It was like this, that I went to sleep and suddenly it started blowing in that place. It started blowing so much and it was in February. It started blowing so much and I started shivering. I didn't know what was this. I was not feeling cold also. I started shivering so much and from my mouth, I'm only saying hallelujah, thank you Jesus, hallelujah, thank you Jesus. But I don't want to say this, but I started saying and I didn't know why I'm saying this. In my mind, I'm thinking, what is all this happening? Like I'm getting so scared. I don't know what is happening. And then suddenly I hear a bird flapping its wings near my ears and the sound was so clear that I got more scared. I got so scared that I said, no, I just want to open my eyes and see now what is happening around me. So that moment, slowly I opened my eyes and when I opened, everything was calmed. Everything, like it was blowing and all that stuff, everything was calmed. And that moment I felt so much satisfaction within me. I felt that peace that I never found anywhere. That peace was so real, that satisfaction was so real. Like someone just touched my life and one thought that came to my mind was, this is God. This is God who touched me. And I was so happy. I was just waiting when it's going to be morning. I'm going to go and tell mom, dad. So this was the encounter that I had with my God, and that day it changed my life completely. So then there was this day where Pastor Royston introduced Brother Vernon to me. So God started using Brother Vernon in my family. He would come, pray over, preach the word, and we both would pray. Even I would grow so much in the word. Then we would have house groups. He would go for house group meetings, and even I would go along with him. Sometimes I would share a word, and this is how God started using me. So even I feel so much peace, so much satisfaction when I pray over people, when I go house to house preaching the good news. So good to see these changes within me, which I never even imagined that these changes are going to come in my life. And to tell you all the truth, that God has really done an amazing work in my life. In 1 year, He has changed my life completely. I didn't think that this is going to happen. I never dreamt that this change is going to come. He handpicked me and He brought me today where I am. Today where I am, it is only because of my Lord. And yes, because of Rofe TV. If it was not for Rofe TV, then I don't know where my life would have been today. If it was not for that call, if I had not obeyed that call that moment, I don't know where my life would have been. All glory to my God. And I would also like to thank Pastor Royston, Ma'am Zelia, Sir Anthony for all their support, for their encouraging words in every way that they have helped me to be where I am today. Today I want to encourage each one of you all. No matter what are the situations you all are facing in your life, if God could change my life from what I was to what I am today, He definitely has a plan for your life as well. He will definitely change your life. It's just a matter of obeying His word. That's what I did. I obeyed His word, and here I am today. You just surrender your life into His hands, and He will lead you and guide you in every situations of your life. With Him, everything is possible. We can't do anything on our strength. If we depend on ourselves and others, we will never succeed in His eyes. Therefore, I say to you all, depend on our God, our true living God, for He is the one who can change your life. He has changed my life, and I believe He is going to change your life as well. Do not give up on Him, because He has not given up on you. He never gave up on me. Even in my life, I went through a lot of ups and downs, but He never gave up on me. He is my true living God. Jesus is the way, truth, and life. You will never find life anywhere else. It will just be temporary. But the life that God gives is eternal. This is what I'm experiencing right now in my life. That divine connection with God, that spiritual connection with God is what I was longing for. But I never had that relationship with my God. But today, I can feel Him. I can feel Him in everything that I do. I include Him in everything that I do. As I walk, as I talk, my God is there with me. I keep on asking Him things and He leads me. This is the relationship that I have with my God. Experience Him, and He is supernaturally going to change your life. Amen.
Son, I'm going to get eggs. You need anything?
No, Dad. Nothing. Wait. Take this some money.
Well, after joining Rofe TV as a video editor, I started reading the word. I started giving word to other people. Then I started worshiping the Lord. I started playing the piano for the services, and you know, it just went on. I started starting to grow day by day, little by bit, and as I grew, I saw changes in me that were never there, you know, as changes with my family also, you know, like I wasn't very very responsive with my family. And when I grew in the Word, I started, you know, responding to my family. I started talking properly to them. And you know, when I used to get very frustrated before when someone used to joke around, but now it isn't like that. I'm the first one who cracks the jokes, and it's been an amazing experience. And you know, when you have this experience and when you grow in the Word, there is nothing to keep you down. You know, devil always you know tries to pull you, you know, gosh, come on Sting, come back to me. But you just have to ignore those voices, and you know, you have to like close your ears, you know, close your mouth, close your eyes, and just walk on the straight path that is of God. And I'm really thankful for Rofi TV. I will like to thank Sir Anthony, Sir Royston, Ma'am Celia, you know, they always believed in me, I'm very thankful for them. You know, even when I did mistakes, they always corrected me. I really found peace over here. Even I did a little mistake, they were like very encouraging. They will like say to you, okay, now you have done a mistake, but see that it doesn't, you know, repeat the next time. And which was very nice, which was very welcoming, which I will always take at the heart. And you know, this will be the most amazing experience of my life.
सारी दुनिया का रखवाला तू सारे दुनिया का, रखवाला तू है यीशु, तू ही तू हूँ। तेरी स्तुति मैं करूँ, आराधना करूँ दिल से, और अंत में नाम हो तेरा, खुशी और गम में साथ हो तेरा, प्रारंभ और अंत में नाम हो तेरा, मेरे जीवन का सहारा तू, मेरे जीवन का प्रभु तू ही तू।
Over the years, God has not changed. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He has worked in Samson, David, Joseph, and Daniel's lives, and including ours, our own. So why not yours?
He knocked at the door of our hearts, and we opened the door for Him. Today He is knocking at the door of your heart. He had a great plan over our lives. And today He has a plan over your life as well.
When you get closer to Jesus, He will definitely reveal His plan to you. So get ready this year to experience His plan in your life.